All right, here we go. One, two, three.
Beneath that mound was the best pal I've ever had. How many, how many are only he? dead in sorrow. No other one could take your place. You'll always be my blue, my darling. I'll always love you as today.
Thank you.
she never could be true. I cry, 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 can't get over her though I try. I boo, 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 should've known she never could be true.
Everybody here, it's Tekoa tonight. All right. Man, it's great to be here. And we came up here earlier today, and we didn't go on the dragon's tail. So we survived. But, man, we always look forward to playing here. This is a great room, and great to have you guys here. If y'all weren't here, it'd end up pretty quick, I'll tell you. But I want to introduce this great band to you. And as you can tell, they're great pickers and singers. And they're also good friends of mine as well. And we get to travel up and down the road together. And we haven't killed each other yet. We've been to Colorado and Maine and California. And now North Carolina. And we still all survived. But, and also I'm really proud to tell you that these guys are the reigning International Bluegrass Music Association's Instrumental Band of the Year. And I want you to meet them. Over there on the banjo that just got done wearing out the Train 45 at the speed of light. He comes from a town in Missouri called Plato. I kid you not. But he's a great banjo player, and also he's a blast to travel with. And if you come up and talk to him at the record table, you better know and be ready to talk about one of these three things: pickup trucks, banjos, or coon dogs. Now, it'll be a good long conversation if you know how to talk about any of those.
You don't have to talk, you just have to listen.
Well, yeah, they'd say yeah and, oh yeah, really? He'd say one of those every once in a while. He's off and running. This is Josiah Schroed on the banjo, everybody. And this guy over here playing the guitar, I've known him for a long time. He's been in the band almost 6 years now, but I've known him a lot longer than that because we grew up around the same area in southern Indiana. And he plays the guitar and sings all the lead and also writes a good song, too. This is Josh Richards, everybody.
Thank you.
Hi, Josh.
Hi, Michael.
How
are you doing? I'm doing good. Oh, it's time to do a song about a fiddle player. A friend of ours sent us this tune. He writes a lot of bluegrass tunes for the some of the bluegrass artists out there. And we had a number one on the charts with this several years ago now. It's been quite a while ago. But, you know, we first heard it, and we really liked the tune. We don't really particularly like fiddle players, but it's such a good, bouncy song. It makes you feel good and happy about yourself that
Josh,
that's why we did it.
Josh. We need to talk.
Let's talk later.
Yeah, yeah. Come to the back of the bus.
Yeah, right.
Oh, wait a minute. What bus?
Yeah, right.
It's bluegrass.
I hope you all enjoy it. And if you can dance anywhere here, get up and dance. It's one called Fiddlin' Joe.
One, two, three, four.
When it came to love, I had enough. We had Fiddlin' Joe. Fiddlin' Joe was a music man. He had the fire in his bow hand. We could wait for the weekend dance. Sweet hair, Fiddlin' Joe. Play us a good one, Fiddlin' Joe. Play it fast, play it slow. One more song before we go. Would you, Fiddlin' Joe? Play us a good one, Fiddlin' Joe. Tomorrow we'll be feeling low. Song before you go, would you, Fiddlin' Joe? Play a a good fiddling Joe. Tomorrow we'll be feeling low. Not one dose of dough.
And with that, it's time to introduce our bass player. And he comes from a town in northern Indiana, just outside of Indianapolis, called Avon, Indiana, and now makes his home around Johnson City, Tennessee, where he goes to the East Tennessee State University, where you can get a degree in bluegrass music. Sounds like they know all about it. If anybody should have a degree in bluegrass music, this guy should, because I think he may like the pick more than I do. And that's saying a lot, anybody who knows me. But he plays the bass and sings the baritone in our trios a lot of the time. And also, if you go to our Facebook page, you'll see pictures of all the stages that we get to play all across the country. And he takes those as well, and tonight's no exception. So I'll tell you right now, if there's anybody here who's with somebody that they shouldn't be with, now's the time to take care of that.
There they go.
Couple leave. Somebody lock that door out there. This is our bass player, Tyler Griffith. How about a hand for Tyler? And our mandolin player, he comes from Charlestown, Indiana. And, well, he's actually from Louisville, Kentucky. I stand corrected. But I met this guy when I was about 12 years old. And my grandparents, none of my family ever played, but my grandparents helped to start a local bluegrass association in Henryville, Indiana. And it was a good place for aspiring players to come and get stage time, and you know, they could put together bands and get on stage. And also there was a lot of parking lot picking going on there as well. And that's where I met this guy. One night real late in a jam session, I heard this guy playing the mandolin. I was like, wow, who is that? I've only heard playing like that on records. And he's a terrific player, as you can tell. And also sings a tenor for the band. And he's going to play you a tune off of our band album we did a few years ago called Come Along Jody. This is Nathan Livers, everybody. Thank you. That's Nathan Livers, everybody. On the mannequin. All right. Well, I know you guys like bluegrass, or you wouldn't be here. And, but do y'all ever listen to any other types of music? What other types of music? Yeah?
Rap?
Rap. Hey, why don't you come up here and do some rapping for us?
Here he comes with a present.
Uh-oh. Just don't scratch up any of that good vinyl. That's the one thing. Don't scratch the Jimmy Martin records. But speaking of other types of music, you know, we do this song. I first heard it from Josh. You know, technology is really amazing. How you can now you can send all kinds of audio and video and everything else just by a text message on the iPhone. And the first time I heard this song was a recording of Josh playing it and singing, just playing it on the guitar. And Josh is a great songwriter, as I told you before, so I kind of thought it might have been something that he had written. And he said, no, it wasn't that. Well, it sounded so bluegrass to me. You know, I've been in bands, you know, where, you know, they look for rock and roll or pop songs, you know, and, oh yeah, we'll take this rock song and we'll make it bluegrass. And sometimes it sounds like that, but this song in particular sounded so much like a bluegrass song that I thought, well, if Josh didn't write it, it's got to be on a Del McCurry album somewhere. And I looked and looked. I got a good record collection, and I couldn't find it. And they finally took pity on me and sent me the original version that was done by Julian Lennon in, I believe, 1984. Had a number one hit with this song. And in case you're wondering, Julian Lennon did not play with Bill Monroe. But you gotta cut that long hair, boy. That's sorry. But we'll play you this tune. This is our arrangement of Too Late for Goodbyes. All right, well, we're going to do you a love song now. You know, if you listen to the lyrics in bluegrass music, even though the tempos, you know, they're usually pretty quick, and the melodies usually sound pretty happy, but if you get to listen to them lyrics, it goes downhill pretty quick. It really does. I mean, it starts on the positive side of things. You got, like, songs about cabins and trees, and a lot of songs about North Carolina in particular, and those are pretty good. Those are good songs. We like those. And then it goes downhill, and then it gets into cheating songs, drinking songs, and then killing songs. And man, if you listen to some of these old songs, they could think of the most creative ways of killing people. It's awful. So, to, I guess, balance it all out, we're going to do you a love song. And this is a song Michael. That we recorded a few years ago. Michael. But come to think of it, somebody does die in this song.
Yeah.
Right?
Yes, sir.
Even the positive songs have death in them. Must be a bluegrass thing. But I think this song tells a good story and hope you enjoy it. It's called The Garden Wall.
Thank you very much. Well, we
That was beautiful. beautiful, Josh.
Oh, thank you, Michael. We're going to feature Michael on one here, and
It's about time.
I think we had a request for this song. Somebody emailed us or Facebooked us or something and wanted to hear this tune. And the song is called Back Up and Push, and I thought that that's what we were going to have to do with the van on the way here.
Ain't that the truth?
We were coming up that big old hill, and Josiah was driving it, and I think he must have had it in first gear because it overheated on us. And we got pulled off the side of the road and thought, oh no, what are we going to do? But fortunately, it came a big rainstorm and cooled everything down. We got here all right. It's a miracle.
Guess that's what happens when you let the banjo player drive.
So hopefully we don't have to back up and push on the way home here, but hope y'all enjoy this. And we're going to take a little break after this tune. And
maybe you guys will push. I'll sit in the back of the van and just laugh at you.
Yeah. We got some T-shirts and we got a new hat. We haven't had hats before. This is the first season for hats, so come check those out and come visit with us. And then we'll be back for some more here in a little bit. So over here on the fiddle, doing all the fiddling and most of the talking for y'all tonight, this is Michael Cleveland, everybody. Give him a big hand.
All right, we've never played this before, but by request, here we go. One, two, three. We'll be back in a little while.
Georgia, through the swamp and the Everglades. There's a hole in Tiger Mountain. God help the man who gets Austin Miller's case. I had a girl and we crossed Georgia, but she had unfaithful ways. Made me feel I was unwanted, like the bats and the bears in Miller's cave. I'd rather fight a mountain hunt in Miller's cave. I said, you'll pay, both you and Davy. I'm gonna see you in your grave. And laughed at me, and then I shot him. I took their cheating, scheming bones to Miller's cave. Showed her I was brave. Most wanted man in the state of Georgia, but they're never gonna find me, cause I'm lost in Miller's cave. If you will, crazy has no fear, then blame it on lonely. Lonely brings me here. It's not the good time friends that bring me to this place, nor the search for another pretty face. It's not the music, smoke, the laughter, or the wine. It's the loneliness that's nearly wrecked my mind. Just call me crazy, if you will. Crazy has no fear, then blame it on lonely. Lonely brings me here. Love right here in my arms. Now she's gone, taken by another's charms. The only thing now I have left is her memory, and the thought of how the way things used to be. Just call me crazy, if you will. There's no fear, then blame it on lonely. Lonely brings me here. Just call me crazy, if you will.
head.
Yeah, buddy. I get it, son.
Dead in Overton Hills. I'm on my way back to your home, and road mines on up the hill. But there's no light in the window, shine on for where I live. Soon as childhood days are over, in this world all alone. I'm on my way back to your home, and road mines on up the hill. But there's no light in the window, shine on go where I live. I'm on my way back to your home, and road winds on up the hill. But there's no light in the window, shine on go where I live.
Request for a tune that was written by the father of bluegrass, Bill Monroe, and as that last one was, but this is one that we recorded a few years ago, and somebody asked for it. Thank you for that. Here's one called The Northern White Clouds.
thank you for asking for that one. That's a good tune right there. We haven't done that one in a little while. It's time to do a song about a train for you. And, yeah, we did one earlier, but it was way too fast.
And,
yeah, we're going to slow it down a little bit, this train song. You know, you got your different kind of train songs out there. You got the one where the girl is sitting on the train and she's headed towards you and it's a great day. Not a cloud in the sky. Doves are flying in the air. It's a beautiful thing, you know? And then you have the other kind of train song where the girl's sitting on the train because she's really, really mad at you. You haven't been listening. You didn't take that trash out like you were supposed to. You hadn't shaved your beard in several months. You know? You know, you left that toilet seat up one too many times. She's out of here, you know?
Did you write this song, Josh?
No, I wish I had, because the Del McCurry Band just recorded this tune.
Yeah.
And, you know, it's a real honor for the Del McCurry Band to steal your songs.
It really is.
Now, we just saw them out there in California, and they've got a great version of this. It's just a really great song, and a guy named Alan Rohde wrote this tune along with the song Garden Wall.
Now that's right, Ronnie.
Yeah. Hope y'all enjoy this one. It's one called That Old Train.
I just heard that city of New Orleans from the past, this old shack of mine. Yeah, the windows carry on and the timbers creak and groan. That old girl is well on down the line. Some people say it don't get cold in Memphis, but I've seen that river freeze up tight. Oh, she used to melt me down till she caught that southern bound, crossed that bridge and left me cold as ice. That old train way on my good times, but the pain is here to stay. That old train is to blame for the bad times I'm having today. Well, if I could, I'd buy myself a ticket, check out every whistle stop that comes along, cover every mile of track, and I'd bring my baby back. I could have an ending to this.
Well, now that we've got her out of the picture, she's gone. We're going to get Michael up here. You know what he can do on that fiddle. I think he, this is just my opinion, but I think he's the best fiddle player out there. Yeah.
I thought you didn't like fiddle players.
I don't like fiddle players, but I like what you do. It's really good.
It's not about the checks, is it?
It's above a fiddle player. It's something different. I don't haven't put my thumb on it yet.
Wizard level.
It's the money.
It's the money.
Your checks in the van, by the way.
But he is not only an incredible fiddle player. He can flat shred on that mandolin over there, and we're gonna feature him. I like to call him Michael Moncleveland.
Oh, that's right.
Now, Bill Monroe did not hit that microphone, you see? Oh, shoot. We're going to feature him on a Bill Monroe song here, I do believe. Which one are you going to do, Michael?
We're going to do one that Bill Monroe wrote about himself. And, he was a big dude. Just like really tall, strong. And Nathan got to meet Bill Monroe when he was a little kid. He went to shake hands with Bill Monroe. Well, this is your story. You can tell if you want to.
I don't have a microphone.
Oh, okay. And he said Bill Monroe's hand wrapped around his about 5 times, scared him to death. And so this is one that Bill Monroe wrote about himself, called The Big Mob.
To change the name of that from Big Mon to Big Cleave, I do believe.
Oh, man.
We're going to have him do another song here that he had an album come out, I think it was last year, called Fiddler's Dream, and this thing got nominated for a Grammy, and he wrote a tune on there. It's a mandolin tune. And he's, Michael has a real, he can write tunes, and then he has trouble thinking of names for tunes. And he listed this song, and the more and more he thought about this song, he thought about being out in the desert. And you're out there and the sun is up real high, you're surrounded by the cactus, or is it cacti? I'm not sure. And you're trying to find your way out of this desert, and you see way off in the distance something shiny out there, and it's nothing but a mirage. And you're very thirsty, and you can't seem to get there. Just keep trying and trying, but you know you're stuck. You're stuck in the lonesome desert.
Oh, that's the wrong song. Sorry.
One called The Lonesome Desert. Thank y'all very much. Isn't that a pretty tune? And aren't you thirsty? I am.
Cool, clear water. Cool, clear water.
Oh, man. Well, now it's time to do another Bill Monroe tune, I guess. A couple years ago, we were in Louisville, Kentucky, playing at a festival, and it was really hot, kind of like you're out in the lonesome desert, except for they put you under this tent that made it even hotter. And we're doing this workshop and playing some tunes and everything, and I'm sweating, and I have this idea that if I recommend that we do this song, I won't have to play anything, because it's just these two guys, you see. And so little did I know that my idea that I had would end up causing somebody to take a video of these two guys, and somebody would post it to Facebook, and over 8.5 million people all across the world have seen these guys just
millions
because.
And millions.
Yeah. Lots and lots of people got to see this just because of my idea.
See, you could have been famous, though, Josh. Just like yeah. us.
I could have been a celebrity, I suppose. But, you know, I was in it. You could see part of me. The back of my elbow was kind of in the frame of the picture.
And
so. Maybe someday, Michael. I should show damn it. No, anyways, these two guys do a wonderful
job. I might
be
better off.
Yeah, you don't want to see it, trust me. Oh. These guys do a wonderful job on this tune right here. It's one called Jerusalem Ridge. Thank you. Michael Cleveland, Nathan Livers, everybody. I am a poor wayfaring stranger, traveling through this world below. There'll be no sickness, toil, or danger in that bright land to which I go. I'm going home. Thank you.
That's our lead singer, Josh Richards. I love to hear him sing that song.
Thank you. We like to do those old tunes right there. We got another one, another old tune. You ready?
There's a few fiddle players in the house. We'll send it out to all the fiddle players.
Oh, yeah. It's a fun one right here.
Hit that big G rod, son.
I'll try. Here we go. Let the fiddle on high ring, you can hear it talk, you can hear it sing. Ain't played no tune called Soldier's Joy, and the one they call the Boston Boy. Trace the phone is Jenny Hinn. That's where the fiddle began. Late in evening, about some down high on the hill and above the town, Uncle Ben played the fiddle on high, rang it, had talk, you hear it sing. Get that monster day when Uncle Ben was called away. Hung up the fiddle, hung up the bone. Now it's time for him to go. Late in the evening, about some down high on the hill and above the town, Uncle Ben played the fiddle on high, drank, hear it talk, you hear it sing.
Well, I'll tell you what, we're going to change things up a little bit. We got a special guest out here running sound with us today. Our regular sound guy who travels with us couldn't make it, and this guy was off and not doing anything, and we twisted his arm and asked if he would come out and run sound for us, but he, although he does a great job on the sound, he's not really a sound man. What he is a singer and songwriter. And we want to get him up here to do you a song. And I know Balsam Range, they play out here quite a bit, don't they? Well now, if you're familiar with that band, there's a song that they did called Blue Collar Dreams. And that was written by this guy who's going to come up and sing a song for you. How about a hand for our good buddy, Aaron Biebelhauser, everybody?
Yay!
Biebelkeeper.
Playing musical microphones here.
Yeah.
Like the musical chairs, but for microphones.
I feel underdressed up here. I didn't bring my tie.
Yeah, where is your suit?
To hide out in the sound booth.
Well,
big thanks to Josh out there helping out
yes,
with the sound too.
Yeah. Well, this is not a song that Aaron wrote, but this is one that I'd love to hear him sing. And we're gonna get him to do it for you. It's called the Kentucky Waltz. Thank you.
sing one night in Kentucky. Beneath the beautiful harvest moon. And I was the boy that was lucky. But it all had ended too soon. I'll sit here alone in the moonlight. I'm seeing your smiling face. And a beautiful Kentucky in Kentucky, beneath the beautiful harvest moon. And I was a boy that was lucky, but it all had ended too soon. In the moonlight, I've seen your smiling face. While I long once more for your embrace and a beautiful Kentucky
Beeblehauser. How about a hand?
Yeah. Thank
you. Son. All right.
I know what you're thinking, ladies, but he's taken. Sorry about it. What's next on the set list that we don't have up here with us?
Hey, I brailled it out for you. Didn't you read it?
That's their hint to yell some songs up to us to play. What do y'all want to hear? Silence.
Ooh, Lost Indian.
That's a good one.
Somebody said the Lost Indian.
Somebody said the Lost
Indian. What?
We'll do the Orange Blossom Special. We'll do that.
Yeah, we had several requests for that one.
See what it is, we don't have to go back on the Dragon's Tail tonight. We're staying pretty close by, so we pick all night. We have been known to do that. Not me. I usually go to bed really early, and I don't do any of that. seem skeptical. Let's try it, Lost Indians.
Yeah, man.
Boy, this, you know, we were talking about this tune the other day. I'm glad you asked for this. We'll see if I can remember it or not. Ready, Josiah?
Yeah.
Here we go, the Lost Indians. Y'all, by request, the Lost Indian. Well, we have had a blast playing for you all here tonight. We appreciate each and every one of you for coming out. And I know there's a lot of stuff going on Saturday night. So we appreciate you coming and spending it with us. And now, a word from our illustrious mandolin player.
Howdy, folks. He finally lets me talk at the end of the show because I say too much.
Well, yeah. Aaron, if he gets out of line, just mute that microphone whenever you,
might as well
you feel like it.
Ha-ha!
Yeah!
There it is.
Yes! Finally!
All right, folks. We would.
I'm so happy.
Come on,
so
man.
Happy.
We do have records for sale, records and hats and t-shirts and all that kind of stuff. If y'all want to come down and do a little meet and greet after the show, it'd be a lot of fun for us. Aaron, back off.
I'm so happy.
I got a lot to say here. We'd also like to invite y'all out to our website, flamekeeperband.com, where all your hopes and dreams can come true. You can sign up for our email list. You can look at our tour schedule. You can read all about coon dogs and red trucks and whatever else about that banjo player over there. And from there, you can go to our Facebook page, facebook.com/MCFlamekeeper. If you'd give us a like, we'd sure like that. Yeah.
Nice.
We do a lot of fun things from time to time. We do live videos on there. I think the most recent one we done was, what, World Fiddle Day? We did a bunch of fiddle tunes by request on Facebook Live there, and that's a lot of fun. If you got your computers handy in your hand there, they got those smartphones. How many of y'all have smartphones? Yeah? Well, go ahead and pull them out there and look up facebook.com/MCFlamekeeper. We'll wait.
They don't have service.
Also, we're going to take everybody's credit card number at the end of the show.
Promise we won't use it.
Much.
Much. We're going to thank our sponsors, D'Addario Strings, Compass Records, Jim Rowe of Rowe Entertainment, Kimberly Williams of East Public Relations, Shub Capos. Yes, sir. Is there anything else, Michael, that you can think of?
Thanks to everyone here at the Stacoa Center, and how about another hand for the guys in this great band? That's Josiah Schroen on the banjo. Josh Richards on the guitar. Tyler Griffith on the bass. And Nathan Livers on the mandolin. Now, I'll tell you what. About 4 or 5 months ago, we had the honor of doing a full concert with the Louisville Orchestra. And it was a Pops concert. They took some of our tunes and put orchestral arrangements to them. And man, it was just a fun night. And but I learned something, man, that in classical, when you play something fast, it's called prestissimo. And I didn't know that. And I really didn't believe it because Nathan told me. And just on principle, I don't believe anything Nathan says.
Well, tell him what you really learned that night, Michael. You learned that I was right.
Once. For once. Okay, so in classical, if you play something fast, it's called prestissimo. In bluegrass, when we play something fast, we say, son, put it in the high gear. And that's what we're gonna do. Here's a song called Leaving Town. One.
Gossip all around, driving up and down on a dead end street. Leaving town, outbound, this highway's setting me free. Done wrong, I'm gone, don't even think about me. Finally got wise, and I'll forgive, but I'll never forget. Leaving town, outbound, this highway's setting me free. Done wrong, I'm gone. Don't even think about me. Don't even think about me. I'm leaving town.
Have y'all ever heard that before? How about that? y'all. You've been a great audience. Thank y'all for coming out.
Thank y'all so much, man. Y'all been a wonderful crowd. Thank you so much for coming and hanging out with us. And I would like to tell y'all that you too could learn to play like Michael Cleveland, just like that song right there. Michael gives lessons on Skype, so if anybody's interested, you can learn to play that just like him. It's a, no money back guarantee though. Oh, we've had a blast here, and we're not looking forward to having to go back across the mountain. We can play a few more tunes for you here. Michael's got one picked out, I think. He does a beautiful job on this song right here. He recorded this song on the On Down the Line album, and he wanted to do this song all by himself, and the band kind of decided that since it's his name on the band and the CD that we were going to let him go ahead and do that. And truth is, he doesn't need our help anyways. We play at quite a few places all across the country, and there's only a few that are like this, though. There's a place in Luckett's, Virginia, that we play at that's similar to this, and then a Cowie school. I don't think that's too awful far from here, is it, the Cowie school? We were there just a few months ago, I think, but these are some of the most fun places to play. The sound is just different in these kind of places for some reason. I don't know why. But.
Well, I heard somebody told me, or maybe I made it up, but I heard that a long time ago that Bill Monroe and Flat Scruggs used to play in this building.
Hey, maybe that's what it is.
There's a lot of history here.
That could be it. Maybe they're
no
looking
pressure.
Looking down on you, man. Thank you all again so much. This is Michael Cleveland on the fiddle. Give him a big hand. Thank you.
y'all so much.